with fruit trees and flowering crab apple trees. In order to get something that's true to the color of flower or the apple variety that you want, you have to take cuttings from the tree that you desire and put it onto rootstock, which could be any seed that you started. And here's an apple tree started from seed maybe 2 months ago. And after a year, we have this guy right here. In order to get a tree that I want, I will cut this off and we take part of this one's profusion crabapple. It was cut from a tree a week ago. The buds are still dormant, so they haven't opened up yet. So this is the right time to do this tree. So this scion was taken last week. I put it in the refrigerator, wrapped in newspaper, kept it wet. And today we're gonna graft it onto this rootstock. You wanna match the diameter of your scion, which is the cutting from the tree, to the size of your rootstock. So you want it to be similar. So we'll take cutting off here. By matching it up here, leaves a groove like that. This groove is gonna fit in the groove that we cut on this tree. Okay, I'm gonna match the diameter of this piece that I cut off my good tree onto this rootstock right here. So we'll put it right there. Now, this tool will cut a matching groove to this in the top of here. Okay, then this should just fit right into there. Perfectly. The cambium, which is a live layer in your tree and your cutting, so that it mashes together. Okay, now we place our wrap on our tree here. Now this, you want it to cover, you always want your the groove on your cutting, not your rootstock, so that covers over and it'll keep it dry and clean. You want to put it on tight so that it pulls everything in nice and tight together. Now I'll put that tape on there to hold it in tight. There you go. We will take this bud off here. I usually leave two or three buds. And then, just to seal it off so that it doesn't lose water. And it takes approximately 2-3 weeks, then you'll know whether the graft took or not. This is a flowering crab apple. It's a little more difficult to do than, say, a pear tree, which is the easiest tree to graft. This is 1 year old, this tree right here. And there's a big pear tree on Elmwood, which is very hardy in this area. It produces a beautiful pear, and I really wanted it, so this is how I get it. And you can see it's all leafing out, ready to go. See, and this is the stock, which we don't really want. I'll remove all this, and I'll leave new growth for it with the new tree. I had some of them, this one I kept in for one more year. I'll put them out this fall, probably. This is a tree that we'll use to graft a good variety onto this rootstock. So we're just using this for the root system. When you got a fruit that can be self-pollinated, like an apricot tree, peach tree, they'll come true to seed and you can actually get a fruit that you desire off of a tree. But a Macintosh apple, it won't come true to seed. So in order to do this, you need to graft from the good tree, Macintosh tree, onto rootstock, whatever it is, and it'll come true as a Macintosh apple. A 3-year-old peach tree. This one is a 2-year-old peach tree. And this is one I took cutting from last year. So that's how much growth. And if you actually look on it, we got peaches this year. So it's enabled to flower. If you take a tree from seed, it's approximately 5 to 7 years before you get any flowers on it. But if you do grafting, you can increase your fruiting to the second year because you'd use a mature wood off of a variety that you desire, right? You look at this tree here, this is a second year tree. So last year it had no fruit on it. Peaches, they can put a lot of growth on in a year. And the fruit on this one is awesome. And it's a hardy fruit, it's supposed to be called Contender. It's supposed to be a zone 4 peach. These ones I've been keeping inside over the winter. As long as they get a temperature of 45 degrees for 1,000 hours, then it's able to flower and fruit. This peach tree was grafted 2 years ago. I graphed it on the bottom where I wanted it, and it actually has some peaches on this year. It actually flowered last year, but we didn't get any peaches off it. And there's the information you need to produce your own fruit grafted tree. There's a peach tree, 2 years old, and it's already fruiting. And approximately another 50 days, you should have them ripen.